Hey, psst, hey, over here.
Okay.
You know.
Hi, you guys.
Here I am.
Ginger Cook. John's waving at me to just tell you really fast that what we're going to be doing in this really fun video is a colorful version of a very famous Vincent van Gogh painting, his almond blossoms and glass vase.
Big words.
So anyway, stay tuned, and we're going to show you how to take something kind of plain and maybe back in the 1800s and bring it up to 2020, shall we?
Absolutely. Here we go.
And the star of our...
Yeah, me now? No.
So, Ginger Cook, and she once again mesmerizes her audience with the daring do's and don'ts of
Okay, we're back to you.
Maybe we should learn sign language.
Well, you don't watch my hands. What good's that going to do?
For all I know, you're on fire. I don't know what's going on. All right, you guys.
We're back.
Painting tonight. We're back. We're talking about old Vincent van Gogh and how we can just go right up to 2020 and paint something that we have done in the past in his more subdued colors and kind of gingerize it a little bit, show you how you might want to do that too. This will be a fun evening. We might, if we have time, do a giveaway. So hang in there with us for that and look for the announcement for that. We've got some marvelous moderators who are with us tonight who are going...
Now, how do you know they're marvelous moderators?
Well, because all our moderators are marvelous, John.
And how do you know any moderators are even on?
Well, I don't. I lied, right? I have no idea.
You know, I'm just throwing this out here.
But we happen to say
we do have Liz and Steffi. I see them off the bat.
See, I wasn't wrong, right?
No, kind of
psychic,
weren't wrong.
Like Conan, you know? Ooh. Cognac.
Cognac.
Johnny Carson, remember that? He had the turban and he'd pretend like he knew stuff. Okay, so anyway.
So you want me to shoot down to the floor there?
Yeah, shoot down to the floor. Here's the thing, you guys. What the moderators do is that when we do have a live chat, if you're watching this later, it doesn't mean diddly squat to you, but it does mean something if you're joining us live, because you have a question, you type it all in cap letters. Sometimes they can give you the question faster than we can. So depending on the group that's showing up tonight to paint this, there may be a lot of questions, there may be none.
Paint or
if
just
you
watch.
Have a birding question, you only want answered on the air, write us ahead of time. You just contact us at www.gingercooklive.gallery. And just say, I have a question.
Us.
Would you answer this on the show next week? Or maybe show me something. I'll do it. And who knows? You might win something for asking. You don't know. I'm not saying you would, but you could, right?
Hey, let's say hello to Sue Sloan. First live I've caught in a very long time.
Hi, Sue. So glad you could make it. Now, we're doing 6x8 canvases. And people say, well, where do you get this? This is not some crummy paper stuff, you guys. This is
real canvas.
And... They're 6x8. I buy them at Jerry's. Sadly, they don't sell them on Amazon. I wish they did. I could point you there. You got to go to Jerry's Artorama. I'll look for them on sale. These are a deal. And the thing I would stress to you, some of you guys, when you're starting a painting, you have some canvas, maybe it's 24x30 or 16x20, and you just start off with that. Do a small one first. Get your feeling of how to mix the colors. Do it, and then do it bigger. Take a moment. Don't be in such a big rush. Take some time, deep breaths, have fun, okay? So, we also have, for those of you who don't want to follow these step-by-step instructions on how to draw this in, we do have on our website our newest one, which is beginningacrylicartist.com. We have for our second, you can sign up for free, but if you want the traceables, they're not free, but you can subscribe for... what do we call
$4.95. That? $4.95. It's a basic supporter.
Basic supporter. If you want to be a basic supporter, $4.95, you get all the information we can give you. Wonderful traceables. John's going to print some out tonight to show you what you would get. In the meantime, let's just take the 6x8 canvas. I have a gold background, just some yellow oxide paint. I think you could have used brown also. And we're just going to go ahead and measure down from the top. I have to put my glasses on. Have you noticed that the print gets smaller every year? Have you noticed that? Just keep making a bit
smaller and
Four and a quarter, I think, is what I'm going to do here. Four and a quarter. One, two, three, four and a quarter. Right there. Now, one of the advantages of owning a T-square or a triangle, I should show you guys the triangle sometimes, they're really fun too, is that you line the T-square up right to the edge, make sure it's flush to the edge of whatever line you're drawing, and then this has to be straight. And we like these little clear plastic T-squares. You can get a couple of them on the Amazon site for like, what, $5 or something, for two or something, really reasonable. Anyway, we like the T-square. Now, you'll notice that Van Gogh, for whatever reason, he had a little red stripe across the top, and we're going to do that too. We're going to come up here and draw that in, which is, what's that? It's just right about 2 inches down from the top, right? Is where that's going to be, okay? So we're going to put that little red stripe in too. Well, we're going to at least mark where it goes. Yes and yes? Okay, so we're going to do that. And again, like that. About a half inch like that. There you go. Done. All right. So you got this red. So this is going to be here and here. Okay. And then, well, we could put the vase in right now. Let's do that. I'm going to show you a little trick on that real fast because I keep getting questions from people. Here's the deal, you guys.
Ooh.
Let's just talk about this. This is the chalkboard coming out. I'm going to use my T-square again.
Your brand new T-square.
It just doesn't want to hit on my chalkboard with the way. Yeah, here it will. Yes, it does. Here, I lied. It will, barely, but it does it. Okay, so here's a line like this. Here's another line like this. These are parallel to the top and bottom of your canvas, right?
Well, they'd really be perpendicular.
Yeah, that's right. It would be
parallel to each other.
Parallel to each other. Good point, Babalooey. That's a good point. All right, so let's just say for government work that you want your vase to be this high. So whatever's happening here has to be the same on the other side, right? Yes and yes? So now you're gonna say that's the top, right? And we're gonna say this is gonna be the bottom, okay? So let's just say for the government work, that's the bottom. So basically what we have a perfectly well-drawn rectangle. Let's curve it around the base like this, and let's just do something like this, and something like this, and you've got your oval. Now, if you want to say that you're looking down on something, the oval gets a little bigger, okay? Maybe it comes down like that. Maybe we're up a little higher when we're looking at it, all right? But basically, that's the gist of how you would draw something like that in. Does that make sense? So this is not really tricky, yeah?
Yes and yes.
Yes and yes. So I'm just going to do that in, let's see, I think I want a different color pencil for that. So again, I will do that. I will take my T-square. I think I want to be about right about there. I'm going to come in over here like this, a little closer to the edge. And I want to go up. I didn't go up as high on this face. I'm going to go up a little higher. I like the one I did before. This was just a fast sketch to see how I'd like it. I want it a little bit higher. I'm going to come down about like that. And then, let's see, that gives me plenty of room over here, I think. And then let's see, let's take this and do the same thing over here. This is going to be the back edge of this. Like, oops, you can't move. Oh, wait, let me put my mat down, then it doesn't move. Good thinking. Here, this is my fancy little mat, and nothing moves on it.
Well,
okay.
We hope.
Well, that's the idea. The mat moves, though, but this doesn't move. All right, so where was I? Oh, yeah, I was here. Like that. How wide do I want this thing? I want it about 2.5 inches wide. 2.5 inches, about like that. Okay. So, I mean, I could have freehanded this in, but you guys want to see how the T-square works. I know somebody's going to say, well, she didn't do the T-square. Why did she talk about it? She didn't do it. Here, let's make sure that we've got some clear range here.
Do you prefer using the chalk pencils to draw on the canvas with?
I do. Kind of just kind of curve the bottom here.
And one reason is it's very easy to remove it.
Yeah, you can just kind of do this. Now, the blue one, not so much. The white, for sure. And then we've got a wide mouth on this, at least this far down here with the... And our lip comes out a little further than the sides of this. So we're going to come around like this, put our lip in. It's a little bit out here like that. There's our oval lip. So that's basically, you guys, That's it in a nutshell. Yes and yes. So I think I'm pretty good here. Now, Yeah, that's it. And if you need to, you can take your ruler. I want you to see, we're going to kind of draw some lines like this. And at an angle, don't get them too, they've got to be pretty parallel. Don't get them too, don't get them too vertical. Last week we did another thing with lines. I saw a lot of you got them the wrong direction. So pay attention to where I'm putting them, okay? Kind of like, yay, this one comes from the, you know, like there and comes up to here. Anyway, they stop at this line. So that's what we got there. So, John, do we have any questions? Why we get going?
Yes, Betty would like to know, are you still going on the cruise on May 10th? I have my ticket, just want to confirm. We're not going on May 10th to the wedding. That's May 25th.
And that, on those... That,
and yes. We're, until we hear otherwise, we are not changing any plans.
And to be part of the wedding, to be with us on the wedding, you've got to have signed up through
our travel
agent coordinator. Just can't show if you show up. We're limited by the number of guests we can have, basically.
Yeah.
And we're at our max. So unless somebody drops out, which they may, then
we did have one drop out. She can't make it. She had a flooding in her basement and needs to rebuild her studio. Was down there. So we do have one opening available. You should contact us if you are interested on one of the many websites.
Yeah, it's a four-day cruise.
It's a four-day cruise leaving out of Port Canaveral on May 25th. I got the wrong glasses on, so I can't see right.
So, all right, so I'm just putting out some paint here. A little bit of Indian yellow, some ultramarine blue, some phthalo blue. No, I guess this was phthalo. We're just going to put out a little paint here. I've got cad red medium.
Emmy would like to know, is there a specific placement for your horizon line?
No, your horizon line is eye level.
You know, this particular picture...
There's no horizon line.
There really isn't anything here.
This is an indoor thing.
Indoor still life.
This is an indoor still life, so you can't really work at it that way. The perspective looks a little different. All right, so... In this case, I followed where Vincent van Gogh went with his. That's why you have, you know, that's why you should pay attention to your photographs. All right, so I'm going to leave the pink out for now. And I've got something called, this is a color called Vat Orange from Golden. And it's very bright and pretty. And I thought we'd grab some of that too. We've got the phthalo green. And we're going to have a little magenta. I think I'll put that down here. And then we're going to have purple. So that's quadrichrome magenta, but golden, and we got a little purple, like that. And then we're going to do some white.
You got quite the setup, my lady.
That's kind of nice, right? Nice bunch of little colors there. And we'll just do a little log of...
Let's do a quick close-up of that so we can...
little log of white here. There.
So we've been using that Indian yellow a lot lately.
Well, this was, it turned out that, yeah, it had been. This is the Indian yellow from
Holbein.
It's called cadmium yellow deep, which is it's really an Indian yellow color, cadmium yellow deep. And then the vat orange is a very light orange. It's almost like a very light orange, vat orange. So.
What's that word you're saying?
Vat, V-A-T.
V-A-T.
Okay. And I bought that tube some time ago. We've never used it. So we'll just do it, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, so let's start with our background first and answer questions as we go. I want to have a damp brush, but not a wet one. So that means I'll put the water in the brush and then squeeze all the water out. And I think I want some white and dazzling purple. I'm just going to come down here like that, start layering this in a little bit, like that, up at the top, right over the gold, a little bit of white, dazzling purple. This is a painting that has lots of layers. So let's take a little bit of white and magenta now and layer over some of that. Do you see while it's still wet? Maybe come down here like this. And let's put a little of that magenta right here. Okay, how about some next to our vase?
Kind of. Do you have the original painting up there with you too? Somebody's asking to see, they saw a different version of it.
Oh, well, no, this was the... This is Vincent van Gogh. That's how he painted it, right?
That's Ginger's painting of it.
That's my painting of that. And but if you want the original Vincent van Gogh, we have that as part of the traceables on our website if you want that.
Well, it may not be there yet, but it will be.
But John's going to put that up. He hasn't quite got that up there, but that's the plan, right?
Hey, look, what would that be Cheryl would like to know, what would be a good substitute for your Indian yellow? Being a primary color.
Yeah, yellow's a primary color, but still, Indian yellow's not bad. If you take cad yellow medium and a little bit of cad red medium, maybe I could mix that for you, kind of show you how close we could get to that. Just a tiny bit, though, not very much, right? And you can see how much of this I would have to put in to get my Indian yellow. Did I get close?
It's
pretty close, right?
Yeah, you're very close. Yeah. So what'd you just use yellow?
Yellow and cad red medium.
And you got pretty darn close.
Yeah, so sometimes you just, you can mix it. Well, when you mix a color, it will not be as bright as the pigments that come right out of the tube, however.
No, because again, that is a primary color.
I'm going to take a little bit of phthalo blue now in white, and I haven't rinsed my brush, and I'm going to come up here and kind of do sort of a blue color up here and kind of overlap this one. Maybe overlap this. See, it's all, you can just... Just if you don't go over it too much, you're okay. If you keep going over it, you just have all one color. So you got to kind of watch that, right? Here's a little bit of the, see, you have to be careful because once you start, blending in, but let's just come up behind here like this and do that under our.
So you're keeping your fingers off the red line.
Yeah, just kind of, just not painting over the red line. Does that make sense? And how about a little bit of magenta and a little yellow? And that's a very pretty color. See that?
That's a great color.
Kind of almost a rust color, isn't it?
It could be perfect for a tractor on a farm.
You could say that. All right. I like this color. I might just take this color as long as I have it and do some lines like this. Don't go through the vase. I'm not going through the vase.
Just kind of sketching them in there?
Just sort of sketching them in. I will paint over them. They will just sort of show up. How's that? See? They're going to show up. If you do them straight up and down, it'll look like the vase. I've seen some people do that. It looks like the vase is just sliding right off the table. The directional line says it's a table. If you get them too vertical, then it'll just look like your table isn't flat. Now, I've got a wet brush, and I'm just going to kind of just, no paint on it. Just, I rinsed it. Just going to smudge some of this in. Okay, just kind of, let's take a little white now and magenta. Let's do a little of this color here. See, just play with your colors a bit. It can be kind of fun. This is still wet, so I put a little white on it. That'll be a little different. Okay, here's a little magenta coming in here like that. We're staying in our kind of our magenta purple colors, and we're pretty good there. And then here's a little bit of red right here. We'll just pop a little red in there just for fun. Okay, so now... let's see, a little magenta, maybe right in here. I don't want that color. Let's see, I want maybe more. Let's take a little ultramarine blue and put it right here. There we go. All right, so this is my first layer on this, and that's pretty easy. So that's not too tricky, right? You didn't think so, yes?
Now, the Indian yellow isn't very translucent, is it?
No, it can be. Depends on the brand. It can be.
Well, how is ours?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
I'm not sure. This is it's pretty opaque.
Yeah, that's pretty opaque.
Pretty opaque. So now, all right. So, I think I'll take my first. Since I have to dry this anyway, I'm going to take my first bit of red, and just come across my yellow like this, and go up and down. Like this and paint over the stripe. It doesn't have to be too perfect. I don't want to tape it or anything. I just want to suggest there's a nice bright orange stripe right there. Okay, so there's my stripe. And then I'm thinking, where else could I put that color? Well, probably some other places, but not this red hot second. How's that? So, not that red hot second. The reason we're painting on this is it keeps these... Apparently these wipe up very easily, these little tablets. I'm trying one out for you guys, see if we like it, okay?
Well, I've used that one a dozen times, and it looks like it's brand new.
Yeah, apparently the paint wipes right off of it, which is kind of nice, and, Is that the only size they make in those, John, or they make bigger ones?
No, they make bigger ones.
Hmm. All right, that's good to know for people that are painting on desks and things and don't want their furniture, their countertops wrecked. Okay, so while that's kind of drying, we're going to get some white and yellow. And I'm just going to come here like that. Ooh, isn't that pretty? That's just cad yellow, medium, and white.
There's really no way to tell which paints are going to be transparent unless until you try it. I mean, I guess some of them,
they Well, they say it. They'll say it, right?
Yeah, they'll say it on the tube. Someone will say that it's a transparent or translucent.
Yeah, they say it. But here's the thing. They do say it. Some paints are translucent because they just don't have enough pigment. Some paints have plenty of pigment and are translucent. So there's a difference, you know, I guess, in quality. All right, take some of this little light orange color here because I'm in the oranges, and I'm just going to come over here like this. Just pull this down here like that. Maybe a little bit of the white yellow again. Let's do another little bit of yellow right here. I got to get a layer on here somewhere. Let's try a little of that Indian yellow. That's pretty. See, that's kind of a neat color, yeah. Just kind of layer some stuff in here. You're thinking this was tricky to paint. I think you're going to find this is very easy to paint. You're going to be surprised how easy it is to paint. Okay. You did put that behind me. All right, so now, and try to get a habit, if you can, of going off the canvas with your brush strokes. Okay. So you can see we've got sort of our little table laid in and just kind of fading out those lines a bit. So they're kind of there, but they're kind of not. Does that make sense? Just they're peeking through, those little lines, peeking through. So.
Just a hint.
Now, while that's drying, I want to show you guys some stuff because we have gotten some really exciting news for you. We've got some new paintings. Oh my gosh, John, table is not close enough by far. Pooh.
Pooh is a bear.
I'm trying to get something and it's just got to be closer. My shoulder barely works right now. I can barely raise my arm above my head. I've got frozen shoulder. I can't reach back and do much of anything. I wanted the baseball, I think. I wanted to show you guys this because those of you who know that while we do a lot of these fun, colorful paintings, we understand some of you want to paint some real serious stuff. And we haven't done a lot of what I consider guy paintings. All right? So I'm just kind of letting that dry for a second, okay? Rather than just do the hair dryer. I haven't done a lot of guy paintings, but I wanted to show you this. Are you back where you can show it, John?
Wait a second. The bear got a little paint on him.
All right. Did we get some paint on one of the paintings?
The bear.
Okay. Well, we'll fix that. All right. So dropped something in the paint. Bad knee. Well, all right. So.
Let's see what I got. Okay.
Let's see. All right. So you're going to zoom out. This is something I thought would really appeal to our senior academy members. Our baseball and glove. I haven't shown anybody this yet.
I think this is
a really wonderful still life, and particularly if you have members of your family that are really into baseball and love it. Who do I know loves baseball? Becky. She watches the Astros, Houston Astros.
I can see Becky doing this one.
I can too, and you could do this larger. I did it this size because we're limited to what we film, but this would be really pretty, 30 by 40. This would be a real statement piece. And so I want to suggest, you know, if you have, you guys, Academy members, this is going to be released really soon. Next week we're releasing, we replaced our Dragon's Eye with the newest version. And that's going to be released this next week, our Dragon's Eye, for those of you who want some more fanciful art. And that'll be in the Senior Academy also. So I wanted to show you guys those things while we could. And I'll put that back and see what else have we got here that I can show you. Oh, yeah. Some of you have asked for more fantasy art, and this is one that's going to be coming up soon, too. This is called Astral Projection, The Harvest.
There you go.
Ooh, Astral Projection, The Harvest. So that's coming up in the Academy. So if you haven't thought about joining the Academy,
Donna would like to have a hockey puck, and a hockey stick.
Oh, that's a good idea.
I hadn't thought of that.
That would go with our baseball.
Absolutely.
Kind of sports stuff, right?
Sporting.
We have ice skates, but that was more of a Christmas thing. But you could leave off the Christmas decorations. We've got some cool ice skates. Okay, so I think this is dry enough to continue on. I hope you guys like that. Do I have any questions I can answer, John, while I'm doing this?
Let me check. Yes, fellas, those were floating yellow balls.
Yep, floating yellow balls. Not for everybody. We understand that. It's a new category in our academy. We've got all the still lifes, so lots of Van Goghs, the various, lots of serious paintings. But we know that a lot of our members, our academy members, are our grandparents or parents, and they're the generation that might have liked some of the paintings that it might want something more modern, and that's just the way it is. They just might feel like something more modern would be more.
We thought we'd start expanding.
So we thought we'd expand and offer some different subjects. You know what? It doesn't. We put out new videos every week for our academy members, or just about every week. I mean, we try to at least. You know, some months have five weeks.
They get four a month, four new video lesson library a month, and then one wave in water.
Yeah.
And sometimes two wave in water if we do a combo.
Yeah, sometimes there'll be something that we can do for both. And but incidentally, the wave in water will also get that one. But wait till you see what the wave in water's getting. Should we show them that one?
Next drawing time,
we're going to show you what the wave in water gets. And now I'm just playing with phthalo greens and adding some colors to that. You can see that.
I think we're starting to confuse some people by using the term senior academy and junior academy. Why don't you go over those a little bit?
All right. As much as I like this thing, I think this is confusing, this thing here. For me, it just adds too much visual noise. So for me, I might paint on it myself, but not when I'm trying to show you how to paint something. I think that band around it's confusing. So I'm I think it is. So what happened was we've had the Academy of Fine Art and Acrylic Painting for some time, and we have lots of members, and they take advantage, a lot of them, of our personal art coaching. And it's really reasonable. We give senior discounts and everything, and it's still under $40 a month. Okay, and we also have a Wave and Water Masterclass. But we had a lot of people say, well, I just can't afford to do that. Would you consider dropping the price? We can't afford to do that either. But we did come up with a way where you could have, we started a second academy, and there's no personal art coaching with it. And there's not new lessons every week like we do in the other, but there will be new lessons every month for sure, and or from time to time. But the thing of it is that we combined, it's for beginners, and we combined the lessons that I felt from watching the personal art coaching were the most helpful to learn how to paint fairly quickly. And that's what we put in there. And what's kind of neat about it is our senior academy members, of course, you know, have that access. They don't have to join another thing. They already have that. That's theirs. They can come over there anytime. But all the lessons that are over there basically are in our senior academy too, though. So there's not really any. The advantage to that, we tell our senior academy members, our regular academy members, what we tell them to do is to, if you want traceable for our YouTube stuff, only for the YouTube lessons, we have those, and we're really expanding our traceables this year and giving you, if there's an original photo, like for instance in the traceables, there'll be the original Van Gogh, there will be, you know, this one, and also, you know, a traceable of what we painted. And so that, you know, you've got, and it's kind of like resources. We think it's kind of cool. I think we really think you'll like it. And what else can I say about it, John? I think that kind of covers.
Well, I think the biggest thing is the, we have 400 plus lessons.
In the senior academy, we have 400 plus lessons and growing all the time. So, but for some people who just wanted to get their toe wet, they felt they were a beginner, They, for whatever reason, didn't want to send me anything for personal art coaching, which always surprised me, but okay. They just wanted to just paint something. And we said, okay, so if I think, I'll tell you what, I think I'm a pretty good teacher. And I think my videos really do explain a lot of stuff. And I think that if you watch the videos and really follow along with these, I think you're going to find that we explain them pretty well. And all of them, I think. And, you know, sometimes it might take watching something a couple times to see, you know, maybe the trick of how I might have done something. But I think it's worth doing. See how I'm just sort of coloring all this in, you guys, as we go and layering? And this is why I tell you to do it smaller, because you can work out your colors, and then when you expand it larger, you don't have to even think about it. You just know where you're going to paint. I tell you what, this one's going a lot quicker than that one. Yeah?
Well, you've already done it once.
That's right. I've already done it once. And if I had to make some changes, which you see I did, I made the vase a little bit taller in this one. I didn't have to wait until to try and change it on a great big canvas. Make sense? I've got all my design planned out on this one. And you can see how fast that comes together. And the only brush I'm using is
half inch.
No, this isn't a half inch, is it? It's a half inch. Gosh darn, John, it's a half inch. Yeah, I'm using a half inch angle brush. And I mean, and if some of this gold shows through for the background, that's fine. That's absolutely fine, right?
So Cheryl's asking, so the senior academy members have access to the beginner academy material, traceables.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
they create their free account,
Free. Yeah, they do. They just have to create the full, but the way the computer's programmed, you have to tell us you signed up and tell us, and then we just, John just hooks you up. You have to sign up with them. You know, you can't use the same password and everything to come up with a new thing, but that's all right. You guys are clever. You can make something up. And the only time you'd probably ever go over there would be to maybe get a traceable for YouTube if you needed it, okay? You could do that. Because, like, everything else is in the Senior Academy. This was strictly sort of in, people ask, can you do something else for us? And so we did, and I think that, and then also, if you're a member of the Junior Academy, and at some point you think, I really need some help with the painting, just come over to the Senior Academy and sign up for a month. Right?
Yep.
Sign up for a month, get the personal art coaching, and then go home. Go back to the junior one.
Senior Academy does have a lot harder lessons.
Yeah, oh yeah, the lot harder lessons, yeah.
They go up to what we consider a box of cookie or the ultimate lesson.
Absolutely. There's like about 50 lessons in the Junior Academy, and they're just specifically designed for beginner artists. And, things that we think, you know, how to paint clouds, there's some back-to-basic videos that, you know, all of these videos are also on our Senior Academy. They're easy to find, and we suggest, you know, if we have a suggestion, if you did this, you need these skills to learn to be able to paint this, you should be able to do that. Okay, so there's my vase at this point, and I think I need a little green here.
Whose phthalo green are you using? Holbein's?
Oh, that's Holbein's, but anybody's phthalo green will work.
Well, somebody's making a comment that they can't get the same color that you're getting.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's try Liquitex phthalo green and see if they're the same. You guys, should we do an experiment? I love questions like this, don't you?
Oh, sure.
Because it's true. I had there's a lady in Houston. I don't personally know her, but my best friend knows her. How's that? Does that make sense? One of my best friends in Houston knows her. So, this is secondhand, but I know it to be true. How's that? So, this lady is an expert on watercolor, and she wrote a book about an inch thick on all the different brands of watercolor. And if you were a watercolor, you'd have to buy one brand of this color, one brand of that color, and she tells you what they all do. And that to me is really confusing. That's enough to make your head just want to spin off, right? Isn't it? I mean, don't you think that's just wildly confusing? But nonetheless, that's true. With acrylics, for the most part, that is not true. You can pretty much just stick to one brand. I'm looking for my, all right, so here's Matisse. Here's my Matisse phthalo green, okay? All right, we're going to do an experiment, you guys, because I know this is the kind of stuff you love, right? So let's do that. Well, like it says, got to dry anyway. Yeah, is it fun? All right. So here's some white, a phthalo green with Matisse, like that. Is that what you're thinking? Kind of emerald. This is the, like the Wizard of Oz stuff, right? And here's some more white with it. All right, so that's Matisse. Yes and yes? Now, here's the Holbein. Okay.
Whoa.
And here's a little white.
That's a huge difference.
Do you think so?
I do.
Do you? Yeah? Well, it's okay. Maybe it might be a little brighter.
It seems brighter.
Does it seem brighter to you? I mean, it could be.
Do you have a Liquitex one, too?
I do. I have a Liquitex around here somewhere. Where'd it go? Liquitex. Ollie, auction free. All Liquitex tubes show up for me. Do you ever say that to your studio? Tonight,
would you consider that a one or two cookie?
It's not one cookie. This is really easy. Because you can trace it on, you guys. So, I mean, how hard can that be, right?
And it's all wonky anyways.
They look green. Liquitex. Oh, maybe that was... I thought I had that, John.
I thought you did, too.
Well, I do. In the storeroom, there's a bottle jar there. If you want to go in the other room and grab it. I know I got one in the closet. If I can't find it on the table. I've sure got one in the closet. We can look at that. While he's getting that, let's continue on with the... But remember, colors change depending on what you put them on. So, for instance, we put this green... You know, there's a little yellow in that green right there. And this you see all these colors. It depends. If you put this color over blue, it's going to look different than if you put it over white. Your brightest colors will always be over white. So suppose you were painting along something happily and you wanted one color, got the same paint, so you didn't want to buy anything else. You want one color that looks brighter than the other. Make like a little patch of white and dry it and then paint over it. And you will see that color will appear whiter and brighter, well, at least brighter than the other. Make sense? So, all right, so we're still playing with that. Let's take a little bit of this orange color and just do a few little stripes now on here. Just to put a little white with that. Let's do a little Indian yellow and cad red medium. Put a little, get a few little orange stripes in here. This is sort of dry. Did you see it?
No phthalo green, no. We're getting low on it.
I thought it was in the, it was in one of those bags. It's in those bags. Phthalo green, I know we have some. It's in those bags.
That's what I looked in, and I have no greens.
Well, all right. Maybe next week we can show you. Sorry, I thought we had it. Could have sworn that it's just sitting
around. Why don't we use this one? It's right here.
Oh, let's use this one. See, I knew we had it. Okay. All right, here's some phthalo green. Now, that's the Liquitex in our great experiment.
Now, wait a minute. Where are you? Because you've moved things around.
I'm right here. I'm here. Sitting right here.
Put it down before you paint so I can rearrange.
Here, right here? This is where we are. This is what we've done. Add a little orange like that, right?
Okay. Now, put your new painting up.
Okay, there. All right, now, we've cleaned the brush off. We want to make sure we don't have any paint on there to contaminate the experiment, yes? Now, here's the Liquitex Phthalo Green. It's pretty bright. Look at that. Here's some white to go with it. Actually, the Liquitex of all of them, I think, is the brightest in this case. I mean, maybe not. Maybe. I don't know.
No.
What do you think? No. That's pretty deep right there.
Well, it's deep, but how thick you put it on.
Well, all right, I'll go back and put layers of this on. That's the Holbein, and there's the Holbein. This is the, what was that? The
Matisse.
So you're pretty much, there's not enough difference where you're going to, you know, but there really isn't enough difference, you guys. There.
Now, is Liquitex a blue shade, red shade, all that?
Yes, it is. This is the green shade. Yeah, red shade would not do that. Liquitex fools around with that. It's a good point. All right, so some of you had asked, what do our traceables look like? And see, we have something right here. And, here we go. There's one right here. Here's one like there. There's that one. There's this one. Here's a color version of that you can have. And then we'll also have up there by tonight, we'll have the Van Gogh, original Van Gogh up there, if you want to just look at that, okay? But you can see that those are...
We give you a lot of materials.
We give you a lot of materials, and we don't think... it's really by the month, it's not per the traceable, so in five, we think that's pretty reasonable. You know, so you have access to this. When you sign up in the supporter category, you have access to that and all the other, everything for 2000 you have accessible to. Make sense? All right, I think I was in the oranges before I got waylaid here with a little color. So here's a little bit of this Indian yellow color. Again, we're sort of layering some stuff on, not getting too crazy, but we want it a little bit brighter, yeah? And if I add a little bit of magenta to Cad Red Medium, that makes sort of a darker red here like that. There's a couple places. There we go. There, and then maybe some pure red right there. Just play with that. All right, so that's kind of where I am so far with our vase and everything. So now what I want to do is I'm going to take a little purple, and what I want to do is I want to come up here. If this was a clock, here's 12 o'clock, so I'm going to cross the vase at 1 o'clock like this, and then just come back like that and do something like this, okay? And then we're going to come over here sort of to the middle, curve it in. Remember, it's got to go inside, so we'll have to paint that back. And then here's the stem gets a little fatter as it makes the curve like this, and then back over to this side, and then swirls down around here like that. So that's pretty easy, yeah? Now, let's see, then we're going to come up here like that and like this. And I think I want this a little bit thicker here. Okay, so remember it's got to go under these two things. Let's put that back for a minute. Let's put that vase lip back like this. Let's just come on over here like that. See, it's got to tuck under there. All right. Now, purple and yellow are friends, but they're opposite each other on the color wheel. So when you take yellow and you add it to wet purple, what you get is muddy brown, right? You get this sort of muddy brown color, which maybe you want brown, but so therefore, if you want some beautiful, bright, lovely yellow almond blossoms with a little pink cast to them, the purple has to dry. So we're gonna take that for a minute, John. How are we doing? We're doing pretty good, right? What time is it?
You're doing good so far.
All right, I'm gonna dry this. All right, so one of the things, if you would like to win 3 months in our junior academy, John can suggest that you sign up. Now, do you have something they can sign on, John?
You have to moderate. I'll see. You'll go dry.
I'm drawing. John's going to tell you how you can win 3 months in the junior academy.
Moderators, I don't know if you saw the link in the messages. And we have a link and a secret word for an entry tonight to win a 3-month membership in our junior academy. And the secret word is monkey. Don't talk yet, boss. No, they got it. And go ahead and start entering. And we will see if we have time to do anything else at the end.
Okay, there may be a surprise at the end. Let's see how we do. Okay, so let's go back to the drawing board, friends. Okay, so you've got your stem that's coming out of here like this, yeah, something like that, whatever it's doing, like that, right? And it's coming up here. Now your flowers are little shapes like this, kind of long, kind of balloon-like shapes, all right? This can be done just with the brush. So think about that as the shape. Now the trick is to go back with the white paint and put those in. So I'm just going to come up there with my brush. Not going to worry about it. There's a little bit smaller one here like this. Got there, and then I'll do 1, 2, 3 here, and then a big fat one right here. There you go, right? And then another little round of white paint. That's a little too much paint on the brush. Let's flatten that out. Okay, here's another one. And I've got a petal that's coming kind of over this one. All right, so far so good? Yes,
and
yes.
And you're laying the white down, why?
Well, we're putting the white because yellow only paints over white. So now, otherwise it's just too translucent. So, which is interesting. It's not the case in oil paints, believe it or not. If you're an oil painter, you wouldn't necessarily find that to be true. But if you're not an oil painter, an acrylic painter. Now I've also got, I didn't put the stem for it, but I've also got another one that's coming this way. So I'll just put, as long as I'm doing the white paint, I'll put that in first. Kind of curve that around like that. Maybe bring that up a little higher. So those are my almond blossoms. And then I know I'm going to want a little yellow on this. So I might just put the white there. Okay. So that's pretty easy. And then you're going, well, then what? Well, this is where you guys get tricky and then think, well, I won't bother to dry it. I'll just put this in just the way it is now. And you don't want to do that. You want to dry. That's one of the big secrets that people don't appreciate about acrylics is learning when to dry. You know, if you just know that, then if you really dried a good layer, then if you put something on and you don't like it, you can just take a damp rag and wipe it off, right? So I want to come up here above this one, come over here about 3 o'clock and just put that branch in right like that. Make it a little bit fatter at the shoulder and thinner right here, okay? So just put that other branch in. As long as we were putting branches in, yeah? Why not? So what else could I do while that white's drying? Well, maybe I could just show you something else. Can I show them the...
Show them the Wave and Water.
I want you guys to see the Wave and Water. We have something called the Wave and Water Masterclass. You don't have to be a master artist to take it. But my feeling is, and it's proven to be true, every month you guys get a new either waterfall, an ocean, a lake, something. Dozens of ways to paint water, not all the same. Eventually, if you paint these and kind of follow the directions, what happens is that you're going to get your own handwriting for water. It'll be probably a combination of several of these videos, back to the old dead artists, to the maybe way I paint water, the ways that, you know, we look around, how to paint water from a photograph, how to paint water from, you know, when you're looking at another painting, all these things. And we've got a challenge coming up, really excited. We got a big challenge coming up for our Wave and Water people with certificates and everything. And where'd you put my water?
Which water are you showing?
The Wave and Water, the big one. Where'd you put it?
Well, the way you were tossing paint around, I certainly didn't leave it next to you.
No. All right. Well, for instance, he's going to show it. This is our bear that we did for this month. Our bear in the waterfall, our grizzly bear with the salmon, which I think is really cool, right? So that's that one. And then John's going to back out, and I'm going to show you the other one, which is really cool. This is some of these lessons are too as much as 7 hours long, not this one, but some of our lessons are very long, and we like to have that. Let me just move that out of the way. Ow, shoulder, ouch. All right, here, check this out, you guys. This is called the Sea of Oz, and because it kind of reminds me of the, you know, the Wizard of Oz and the Emerald Sea. So this is called the Sea of Oz. This is a 20 by 20 canvas. We think this is really fun. I'm going to show you a fabulous photo that we took this from. And this is a really, really less, about 5.5 hour lesson that's soon to be released for our Wave and Water Masterclass. So I hope you guys like that. Huh?
Yeah, soon to be released after I go through all the editing.
John's got about 3 more hours of editing on it.
And we have a challenge piece to go with that.
And we have a challenge piece to go with that. So that's really exciting. We have a challenge piece to go with that. Now I think that's, I'm going to hit that one more time with the dryer, John. Just real fast. I don't know that you have to do much.
I will. I just mute you. All right, remember to do the entry form. We'll be drawing for that shortly. If you're interested in a 3 month, if you are a current member and win, you'll be able to get a downloadable of your pickings. So even if you're an Academy member, don't feel that we've left you out. And you're back.
All right, I'm back. So now, if you've been playing with purples and other colors, then either get a clean brush or make sure that your brush is clean. Wipe them off, you know, make sure it's clean. It doesn't have any of these other colors on it. So I'm going to start with a little bit of yellow and a little bit of white, just a tiny bit, but more yellow. And I want to just come up here on this. See, look how bright and beautiful that is. And let's just, boy, if you want some bright colors, that's the way to get it, okay? Now I want a little more white on this one. I don't maybe not that quite so light, but here we go. And this one.
A little paler yellow.
A little paler yellow. Let's see, there we go. This one's yellow. Do I want any of this light yellow anywhere? I think I'm pretty good, but here we can just, we can add a, just a spot of that somewhere on our table too. Now I can do, because it's yellow, I can do a little bit of white and magenta and get a little pink color and add that, and that's not going to mess my yellows up. And take a little more white and kind of go over this petal and maybe say this one, so it's got a little bit of a peach color to it. That one needs a little bit more yellow. And get in the habit of just kind of putting a brush stroke down and, you know, don't keep going over it. Put it and keep, move on. Put a brush stroke and move on. Kind of get in the habit of doing that. I think that's good. Let's see, I think we said we wanted a little yellow for this branch here. Right in here like that. Maybe I want a little yellow going down this way. Okay, and I want any of this color over here, maybe just a little bit of this deeper Indian yellow color on a couple of these. There we go. Toop, 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 toop.
And what color is your trunk?
This what?
Your trunk.
It's purple.
Just straight purple?
It's purple. And it's got a little couple of little highlights on it. Okay, and then if I want to, I can go back over it. I wanted my trunk a little bit wider than that, so then I come up on this side with it and just kind of knock back some of that yellow like this. Here's the other side of the trunk. And I'm going to widen it up right here, right at the base. There you go. Something like that. And then maybe I might come in here. Let's see. I'm going to wipe the brush off. And let's go into the greens and phthalo green and white. And let's do another layer of color. Here we go, like this. I think I want a little yellow with that and white. There we go. Come a little light on the inside. Let's just go over the, this dried now so I can do that, right? Remember the, remember what's over and what's under. Don't get confused. This is over. That's, that branch is over. That's under. Yeah. There you go. This is a little bit lighter right here. There's a little bit of light right here. There you go. Remember it's water. So you don't know, we see everything. Yeah. Maybe I want a little, and the thing with this is these angle brushes, you can get such a thin line with them, or a fat line. That's what's so cool about them. And, for instance, I know that right next to this yellow would show up better if it was dark. So if I put a little bit of dark purple right there, or maybe a little magenta and purple on this side under here, maybe just a couple places, that shows up more. That little flower is just going to pop right up. So I say here's a little bit of a little bit of a, maybe it's just a little purple here. So we didn't outline, you see that, we didn't outline the vase. We just, we did the vase with colors. And we did the, he had, if you look at his original, he had probably more striations in his than I'm putting in mine. This is a little phthalo blue and white. But that's all right. The idea is to put the color in, and I want some color going this way. A little bit of blue here, going out like that. A little bit of blue, kind of purple. It's almost periwinkle, isn't it? And because that's just whatever was left on my brush. Also, when someone says their colors don't go, keep in mind, and this is real important, that monitors show differently. I mean, your monitor may look one way at something and then not. Does that make sense? So my monitor may show something very bright green. If you looked at it on your phone, it may be some other color. Here's a little bit of bright phthalo here like this on top of that. And I'm just going to pop over that red real quick. I'm going to put some bright phthalo green right there. See, brighten that up. Sometimes another brighter color is helpful. I think I had, I'm just looking at here. This is fairly easy. Let's just put a little blue, or just put a little green right here. Maybe there's just a little green on some of these boards. Just coming up this way.
Okay, we're going to be drawing for that giveaway here shortly, so get your...
And if you're already an Academy, Senior Academy member, and you win it, then you can win it. It will let you change it for a downloadable lesson. Okay? So everybody can win something tonight. And we don't care where in the world you live, if you've got internet. And if you do not have good internet, and you don't feel that you can watch it, then we'll switch you out for a downloadable lesson. So, you know, you've got some choices, you guys. If that's helpful. And what's a downloadable lesson, John? Maybe you'd like to explain that to people.
We offer a lot of our lessons we have on our downloadable website, which is gingercookondemand.com.
Which?
For those people that don't have the best of internet or want to own a lesson, add it to their personal library.
Like the Back to Basics are such a good group.
The Back to Basics series we have, it's got almost over 12 hours of videos in it for $50, and you've got everything you need to learn all the basics of the ginger cook method
of painting. And incidentally, if you've already bought the Back to Basic, if you bought it before Christmas, we added some new videos, and you have access to those even if you bought it last year. Just go up and look at it again.
Occasionally, we'll add things to that set, so you may want to check your account periodically and see if you've got something new added to it.
For details on how to add or remove accounts, tap more info.
Always one of the devices is talking, isn't it?
Okay, there's a little bit of cad red, a little bit of orange. Here, let's just do a little bit of this light orange color. Okay, on that one. And I think I even had a little bit of pink in there, too. I think I did, just a dab of that, of the magenta. Okay, like that. Then we're going to come back here with our bright reds. Dot of color in there. Just take a little bit. I want a little brighter color right there. All right. Sometimes with reds, you can just go over them again, and they give you some nice colors. So you can see, now you'll notice how bright this stripe is compared to the, can you see how bright this stripe is compared to this one? And what I discovered is that just, you know, one of the problems with watching anything on an iPad is your iPad is backlit. So it's always going to look brighter on your iPad, and you can make yourself crazy trying to get something that bright. But if you take Luminous, this is Holbein's Luminous Opera, and add it to Cad Red.
You got yourself a hot color.
I want you to see what happens.
Whoa.
Look how bright that is.
I need sunglasses.
I'm telling you, isn't that cool? And that's there. We're going to do that again. We're going to do a little bit of that up in here in the flower, just a little bit of that. Dots up there, a little bit of that color, a little bit of up in here. You see how much brighter that is? Isn't that cool?
Now you're bringing it into 2020.
Yeah, now we're just, and I'll tell you what, one of our friends was telling me that she had visited an art gallery recently in a pretty big city, and they were telling her that was really in, that they wanted paintings with lots of color. That's what, you know, people want, is lots of color. And this is sort of a painting like this really does have that, doesn't it? So
it's a whimsical color.
Yeah, it's a really whimsical color. In fact, I want to.
But you're taking an old classic and you're just making it.
Yeah, we're
taking
an old classic and we're making it. We're just kind of remaking it. And I think I want to extend this up a little bit. This petal up a little more. There, bop into there like that. There we go. Just kind of bring that blossom up. Now, one of the things that he had that was very interesting on this was he had a lot of... Van Gogh liked to outline quite a bit. So what we're going to do, too, is we're going to... let's see, that's too dark. What we're going to do is just do a little bit of outlining in those flowers, too. All right, so let's see. Just pull some purple down in here. All right. So you can see how quickly something like this comes together. I might take a little bit of this color and just do this.
Donna says, I'd like to see under the water marine life. Have you done something like that?
We have. We have actually one of that in our, you bet, in our Wave and Water Masterclass.
Yep. I don't remember what we call that. Sea something.
Under the sea or something. We sure
the
did.
The wonderful world of under the sea. Something.
Yeah, we sure did. It's a little bit of white now.
That's one my sister did. She painted it.
Yeah. All right. So we're just adding a little bit of highlights on our vase now, a little bit lighter. Just give us a little bit of light. Now we need a little bit of darker in the around the flowers. Okay, so that's, I think that's kind of cool, don't you? I think this is kind of neat how this
all paints out. Yeah, Luminous Opera comes from Holbein.
Yeah, it is Pepto-Bismol paint for sure. You know, that's that color you cannot mix it. You know, red's a primary color, so you just can't make those. And that's why, you know, and that's fine. You just can't make them.
Just kind of dark in
that corner. You got to buy it. All right. So you absolutely have to buy it. Here it is all by itself, a little bit of that right here, a couple dots. Like maybe up here we'll do a dot of it. One, two, there. You can see it really brightens it up. And then if I wanted this even brighter, I'll show you this, the same color, right? If I wanted it brighter still, I'm going to go right on top of this red stripe with that color. And that would brighten it up even more.
You definitely need sunglasses now.
I'm just saying, well, your acrylics try darker, so, you know, I could put a little bit of the, see how much darker that made it? So when I just put that cad red on it.
Karen would like to know, is Ginger doing anything for Acrylic April this year?
Ginger is not. Ginger's getting married in May, and John and I are will not be available for Acrylic April. We'll have videos for our Academy members and for YouTube. We'll have some fabulous videos, but we'll not do anything special for Acrylic April. As much as we would like to, maybe next year. But we're too busy. I know my daughter's got a lot of stuff going on for Acrylic April Cinnamon. And I'm very proud of the fact that she does. But we, unfortunately, we're not, we just don't have the time. If you realize how many videos we have, two academies, Wave and Water Masterclass, and YouTube, and we work 24 hours a day, you guys. I don't know when I'd fit this other stuff in, and when we, you know, so can't do it. But it'll be fun. Acrylic April should be a lot of fun for everybody. But we will have challenges, and we're going to have some great challenges.
Yeah, you know, we already thought of some beauties.
We're going to have some great challenges for people, but there won't be any specific videos for that. How's that? Does that make sense? Put a little bit of magenta in this pile right here like that. Put a little bit of magenta down in here. And our instead, there we go, like that. And let's pull a little bit of light right here. There we go. There. I think this is fun.
Looking good.
I think that's pretty much, I think that's pretty close to being finished. I think I could take a pen and finish the rest as far as the, you know, these, around these flowers. I could take a pointed brush too, and somebody asked me about that. Remember that last week I showed you that pointed kit? So if you need to do something like that, and if you need to do some outlining on something, use a fluid paint and a liner brush like this. And that way you can, if you need to outline something, just kind of hold it vertical. And you know, not all of these are outlined, but if you need like a little outline somewhere, you see how easily that works. So the same with this right in here.
I was pretty impressed with those brushes that came with the.
I mean, for $18, I couldn't believe that. I mean, these were.
Well, I used that to do some of the backgrounds after we were done.
Yeah.
That brush was really nice.
They did. I thought the brush set was really nice. And it's funny, you can't buy them by themselves, and you can't buy bigger tubes. That was the downside of that whole thing. I think they missed the boat by not allowing you to.
Well, I think they're just trying to introduce themselves into the market.
Well, maybe they just couldn't launch everything. But if I were them, I would sell the individual tubes too, of stuff
and
that people
ones.
Wanted to get.
All right, folks, get ready. We're going to do the drawing. Last call for entries into the drawing. We've got 151 of you participating in this exciting event.
All right. So you can see how
we've got these. 417 of you.
That's right. Look at that.
Ginger, have you ever thought of painting Crocs?
Somebody asked me that today, if I'm painting my Crocs. And I have gotten paint on Crocs, not necessarily deliberately, but I've definitely gotten paint on them before. How's that? It's just gonna.
And I can attest to that. She has paint on everything.
Here we go. I just wanted to pop up a bit of color somewhere, and then maybe put a bit of color right here. There. I think we did pretty well with that. You know about you guys, but I think this is kind of pretty. I think it came out really well. You kind of saw how quickly something like this can come together. This would be very pretty larger. I'd like to see this, 16 by 20 or 24 by 30. I think big and colorful like this would be marvelous. And I think it would look really cool. All right, John, how are we doing here? I'm just putting a little. Go ahead and do the drawing.
We are going to do a drawing. We use random.org. 151.
So there's our colors. Just kind of play with the colors.
And we have a winner.
Oh, yeah? Who won?
I have their number.
He's going to tell us in a second here.
Let me highlight it so I don't forget who they
are.
Yeah,
just highlight it so you don't forget who they are. And I might take a little bit of white paint here. And do this.
I won't say it because the words are so different than the transmission. So, the winner is.
Wow, that's fun. This is so fun, isn't it? Yeah, our lag time is so different, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, it's like the delay on radio or something. All right, so what do you want to know for sure? You want to make sure that you've got the, your line straight.
So the winner is Kara Renee Clark.
Kara Renee Clark. Well, congratulations, Kara.
To contact us on gingercooklive.gallery or beginner acrylic artist. .com.
Yeah, there you go. Tell us what you'd like to, who you are, and we'll send you an email. So I hope that was fun. So any particular questions on this? Does anybody have any questions?
Questions on this painting for this evening?
I'm going to see if I can write my name with this pen. Look at that, you guys. That brush, that's pretty good.
That's really a nice little, that's a great brush. I'm sorry, that's.
That's really nice, isn't it?
I mean,
let's do it in black here. Okay. Usually it's kind of hard to write your name in color, with a brush because it's that's not going to show up even.
Next week we'll be back on March 2nd already.
You want to know what we're going to be painting next week? Should I show them?
No.
No, you don't get to see. It's really cool, though. So another really colorful stuff.
When will the baseball painting be in the Academy? By the opening pitch. I don't know when that is. When is opening pitch? Anybody know? I don't know. No, Becky
It'll be
knows.
Sooner than that, John. It's just,
I'm doing the Dragon's Eye, and I've got the Bear. Those are two big ones. That's another big one.
Yeah. Well, you've got the
After the
you've done the bear, John. The bear's already been released.
Not the bear. The other ocean.
Oh, the other ocean. You've got the
I've got the other ocean.
The harvest one.
Yeah, I've got the harvest one.
Yeah.
It'll be coming up soon. Let me get the one that I'm working on now. I guess I'm working on the harvest one now. Is that what I'm working on?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, that was the long one.
And so make sure that these curves follow each other.
How big was his original? Do you know how big his original was?
I don't.
I don't know. Don't know offhand.
I have no idea. You know, again, just I don't know.
That brush he's using right now came with our Salvador kit that we got.
Yeah, that Salvador paint kit. There was like 19 brushes or something that
It'd
came
be 12
with
brushes.
12 brushes with a lot of brushes.
24 colors.
A lot of brushes, right?
A lot of brushes.
Yeah.
$18.95.
Yeah. And it came with all those paints, and, you know, the paints were fun.
Yeah, we figured that's going to be a good traveling kit. Take some 6x8s and that and color good.
Yeah, just get a big white. And for those of you, I want to give a shout-out to Michael Fettis, who's in Arizona right now. And he's actually lucky enough. I don't think he actually plays baseball, but he's going to the spring, you know, spring training, he said. So,
well, and he could play for all we don't know.
We don't know. But anyway, Michael, what I was going to tell you is that he's saying that he's running into trouble with how fast his acrylic paints are drying out in Arizona. And Michael, try adding golden open white to your other paints and see what happens.
That's a good idea.
And that does work. So that's just, you know, a little trick of the trade, you guys. Let me put this brush back in water. So, see, I think I need to have a lighter stripe through here. There you go. And I think this was sort of fun. How are we doing? We did pretty good, right?
Yep, you're right on time.
A little just over an hour to paint this.
Hour 15.
That's not going to take you long at all.
Nope. It's a good whipping, you know, there's not really a right and a wrong. I mean, if you get the general idea, you've got it.
Yeah, just try to keep your warm and cool dry before you keep layering colors. That's the secret. And remember, this is round, not straight across. Keep your stuff at an angle. Take advantage of the tools that we have, like T-squares or triangles, that kind of stuff, right?
Absolutely.
And next week we'll maybe talk more about triangles, just because I think that needed to know. And I think that answered the questions. When we looked at the different colors of green, they've had a chance to dry now. I think we said that was Liquitex, right?
Yeah, Liquitex on the top.
And that was
That's
the Matisse, and this was the Holbein, right?
Yeah, I still like the Holbein.
Well, you know, it's got a bit of a shimmer to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it just seems richer.
Yeah, and again, this is all, you know, everybody sees colors slightly differently, but they're not so different you couldn't use any of the brands.
No.
Right?
No. Nobody could tell what you did.
Also, the last thing I want to do for you, because this has come up, you're going to say, Ginger, I don't own any phthalo green, and I want to go out and buy any phthalo green. So if I didn't have phthalo green, what could I do? So let me show you. We're going to take some white, and we're going to take some phthalo blue, and we're going to just make this color, and we're going to add a little bit of yellow to it. Okay? White, yellow, and phthalo blue. Okay?
White, yellow, phthalo blue.
And this is the color you get. All right. Now, it's not as bright, is it?
No.
So most of the time, phthalo green is too circusy for most paintings, right? It's a little circusy. Now, let me show you what happens if you add white to that. See what I mean? It's just not the same. It's a little grayer. So again, we're going to go yellow, phthalo blue, and white. I got some pink in that. So
got a lot
never
of pink mind, in that.
Never mind. Never mind. That's a experiment one. Let's come on over here. So let's get it really white. See? Let's put a lot of light color with it. See, this is phthalo blue that's white. Okay, that's phthalo blue. So if you added a tiny bit of yellow to that, not very much. You know, the trick is you don't add very much. And there's your light green. It's just not the same, is it? So when you need this sort of Wizard of Oz emerald green color,
you really need to buy some phthalo blue and green.
Yeah, you just kind of almost need to get that. So, but not everybody likes, you know, in-your-face green either. So, it's just certain things. The same thing with diazine purple. Did you know that? So here's diazine purple, which is really white, and then add white to it. That's really in-your-face, okay?
It's a great purple, though.
It's a wonderful purple, and that's why we tell people to buy it. But if you just did blue and red, you'll never get this color.
It won't be that rich.
It won't be as bright. You'll get some sort of version of it, but you won't get that bright. So when people say, when you say things like, I can't mix colors, sometimes you can't. It's not you. It's just you can't. Okay? Does that make sense?
Sure.
All right.
So I'm not sure if we even saw any of that now.
So the question we've asked people all week, and we're going to ask you, is what? Tell us what your favorite paint is and why. What's your favorite brand of acrylic paint and why? That's what we want to know. We had some of it on Facebook told us what they hated. I want you to tell us what's your favorite brand. Maybe it's your favorite color. What's your favorite color and brand of paint? Tell us why.
Yeah.
And other people will read that. Maybe you'll inspire somebody to, again, maybe you'll just want the luminous rose and Holbein, but you'll buy everything else, say, in golden, or you like one thing. So less about what you don't like. Tell us what you like, and we'll talk about it next week.
All right. I think we're good. We're all clear. We'll be back next week, March 2nd. Be sure to subscribe to us. You never know if we may pop up live at an undetermined time. Sometime we just sit around staring at each other and say, hey, let's go live. You never know. It may happen. Thanks, everyone, for joining us. If you haven't subscribed, do so now. Hit that little bell so you'd be notified.
And those of you who contributed tonight, we appreciate it very much.
Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful evening.